In this video, you will learn how to create this beautiful and fancy looking 3D pie chart. Before you raise your concerns about the use of pie charts, let me give you my disclaimer. Personally, I prefer column charts over pie charts because for a human eye, it is much easier for us to judge the height rather than the angles in a circle. The issue gets even more complex when you add 3D to pie chart. There is always a possibility of misrepresentation of data when 3D pie charts are used. However, there are certain things that you can do to ensure that all these issues are reduced. The first thing that I personally do whenever I use pie charts is, I never use a pie chart with more than 5 segments. Because when you use more than 5 segments, it becomes almost impossible to judge the angles. The second thing I do is to clearly add data labels for each of the segments to take the guesswork out of the equation. The third thing I do is to use clear, bright, distinct colors for the segments so there is no confusion about the angles. So when you take these precautions, you can definitely take advantage of the attractiveness of pie charts, which can really come in handy to get your message noticed. So in a marketing video or sales video, there is always a possibility of making your numbers noticed when you use an attractive pie chart. And that is why I'm showing you how to create these pie charts. So with that context in place, let us learn how to create this beautiful 3D pie chart. Let me insert a standard pie chart onto the chart. Let us go to Insert, then go to Chart. And here we have the option for pie charts. The usual pie chart that is used is this 2D version. Now we are going to create a 3D version to make it look fancier. So let me choose the 3D pie version and I'm going to say OK. The default look and feel of the chart is this. And if you're going to just leave it the way it is impossible for the audience to understand the information here. So we necessarily have to do some modifications. Let me just close this first. Let me remove this legend. Let me remove the title. I firmly believe that whenever you use a chart on your slide title should mention what your chart is about. So I don't want to include the chart title here. Now let me resize it. This looks beautiful by itself. Now we are going to make a few interesting modifications. Let me right click on the chart and let me add data labels. And let me add what each of those data labels represent. So let me right click on the data labels and then say format data labels and say what is the category name. Now here we are very clear about what each of those segments represents. To increase the font size, I'm going to click on the bounding box here and then increase the font size so the font size of all the text elements are uniformly increased. The next thing I'm going to do is to use bright colors. So let me click on the pie chart here. Now that selects all the segments. Then let me click on this specific segment and then let me go here and choose a bright color. Then let me go here and choose another bright color here. And I'm going to continue the process by selecting these kind of clear, bright colors. And wherever the data labels are not readable, you click on the data label once and you will have all the data labels selected. And then you click again on the specific data label and then make sure that the font color is very easily readable. The next thing we are going to do is to right click on the chart, then go to this option here called 3D rotation. Now, this is what makes this look fancier. What I'm going to do is to add a perspective. Now, when I reduce the perspective, you can see that this is how the angle changes and it looks really nice. You can see that this kind of tapering happens and that gives it a very distinctive look and feel. Now, you can see that this 3D pie chart looks as if it is floating in mid-air. To make it stay grounded, you can add some shadow. So let us click on the chart, go to the effects option, go to shadow and choose one of these outer shadows. Let me choose this one here called as outer center. Now that looks good. If you want to increase the size of the shadow, you can always do so. You can add a little bit of a blur. Everything is possible, just as if this is a regular shape. Now at any point you don't want the outlines here, you can always go to shape outline and say no outline and the chart looks much cleaner. You also have the option to play with the material in 3D format. So you can go to material and you can play with the different options here. Can you see here? Each of these options makes the chart look different. You can choose the look that you really like and make your chart stand out. Another thing that you can do to make the edges look shinier is to go to top bevel, and you can use any of these bevel options here for the top layer. The best way is to try the different options under 3D format, 3D rotation, perspective angles, shadow, etc., and come up with a style that you personally like. Whenever I want to make a point using pie chart, I make sure that I have my specific label clearly distinguished from the others by using a different font type. Like in this case, I'm going to use 2cmmt condensed extra bold, which is distinct from the usual calibri. I'm going to increase the font size so everybody knows that this is what I'm talking about. And to make it even more distinct, I click on the specific segment and pull it out slightly so it's easier for the audience to see that this is the segment that I'm talking about. So as long as you are clear about how to use your 3D pie charts the right way, you'd be able to impress your audience with your pie charts. Now let me show you some creative templates taken from our comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle where we use pie charts. The first example is this one. Here you can add a bit of pizzazz to your pie chart by adding this frame around the regular pie chart. Another thing you can do to draw the viewer's attention, as I mentioned earlier, is to pull out a certain segment that you want the audience to notice. Another way to make your pie charts noticeable is to add some kind of a texture that makes the pie chart noticeable. Now, if you want to take your pie charts to a whole new level, you can try these fancy pie charts. And these are available ready-made in our comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle. And this whole thing is totally editable. You can right-click and go to edit data, and you can always change these values and they will reflect in the pie chart. These are beautiful pie charts that your audience might not have seen regularly. Another way to draw the viewer's attention is to use data-driven donut charts. Donut charts are particularly popular in infographics. Another stylish variation of a donut chart is this dial chart, which shows percentage completion. However, if you don't have the time to create these kind of attractive data-driven charts for yourself, you can always choose our off-the-shelf solution called Comprehensive All-in-One PowerPoint Bundle version 2.0. This bundle has more than 4,200 premium PowerPoint templates that allow you to visualize pretty much anything you have in your mind. The link to this useful product is in the description box below the video. Click on the link and check out more details about this product. By the way, did you like this tutorial about creating this fancy 3D pie chart? Then you will really love this other video that we have put together for you that shows you how to create data-driven charts in a creative way. So go ahead and click on this link to watch this video and take your data-driven charts to the next level. I'll see you in the next video.